name is Jim Bain. I'm a professor of electrical and computer engineering at Carnegie Mellon, and I also serve as the associate director of the Data Storage Systems Center here. My research focuses on information storage technology, the physical systems which store information, very small devices with interesting magnetic and electrical properties that are used to actually encode the ones and zeros that make up the binary information that is all over our phones and in the cloud and so forth. Our society has developed a huge hunger for digital information. Photographs, email, in business, geological information. I mean, it's everywhere. People estimate that the entire information universe, as they like to call it, consists of about somewhere between 5 and 10 zettabytes of information. Right now, if you took all of those pieces of information and packed them at the density we can pack them at, they would take up areas somewhere between the size of Manhattan and the size of New Jersey. So shrinking these things allows us to have room for them, allows us to manage the power they consume. The kinds of things we do in this lab, we look at the physical phenomena that are used to store information and try to find new phenomena that we can use, phenomena that will be lower power, higher density, allow us to make devices smaller, allow us to make them last longer, and generally, how do we shrink the system? You know, how does your iPhone have 8 gigabytes of storage today and have 64 gigabytes of storage tomorrow and a terabyte of storage at some point in the future so that you have a whole bunch of movies right on your iPhone? You can't just make things smaller and expect them to work the same way. So we have to either fix the problems that happen as a result of them being smaller, or when making them smaller and smaller makes them just not work anymore, we have to find a new physical process. So there's a couple of examples of how you might see this research emerge into the world. One of the projects we're working on is called heat-assisted magnetic recording, and that takes traditional magnetic recording and adds to it this thing we call heat assist. It's actually bringing a laser to shine on the surface of the disc in addition to all of the other magnetic fields and so forth that are used to do the recording. One of the ways we do that is we use these things called plasmonic structures. We guide light, instead of guiding light like you would guide it with, say, an optical fiber or with a mirror or with a lens, you can guide them with very small structures of metal. Pieces of gold, little tiny gold wires that are only maybe 100 atoms in diameter. And we use these structures to guide light to the surface of a hard disk drive. Things get very hot for 1 or 2 nanoseconds and cool down again, and that assists in the recording process. Probably that reaches commercialization in the next few years, but it's been the subject of sort of basic research since about 2000, when people identified that without it, without this energy assist, without this heating, they would not be able to record at densities above about where conventional disk drives are. So there's real kind of impact from this work, but there's also some really neat science that goes on at understanding the fundamentals of these nanoscale devices.